I want to talk about a concept that is very interesting that came from a clinic that a doctor who lives at Ananda Village operates, and it serves a large group of patients throughout the local area where we live. And the clinic has three aspects to it. The first is, obviously, it is a medical clinic based on Western allopathic medicine. They have wonderful staff and much of the equipment that you need. It also has a dental component to it that allows patients to come and have all the dental work that they need. But the third aspect is that they have counseling services available. And what our doctor does, Dr. Peter Van Houten, is a model that has been followed throughout the whole of the United States. He's quite well known, and he gives lectures on the topic of integrative medicine. And integrative medicine recognizes that even though you're seeing a patient for, let's say, a problem of high blood pressure, that problem with high blood pressure, if taken only in isolation, doesn't recognize what's going on in the patient's life. The high blood pressure may come because he's smoking. He may smoke or drink alcohol because he's stressed. And so the root of the problem is not in the blood system, but in some psychological area. And so instead of just treating the blood pressure, they may refer him to a counselor. Now, this is often done throughout medicine all over the world, but they do something different called a warm handoff. If they simply write out a prescription for somebody, let's say a normal doctor's office says, well, you should see a counselor, and they give a prescription to see a counselor, 75% of the people never end up taking that act. But with a warm handoff, the doctor actually takes the person from the medical clinic to the adjoining offices of the counselor, introduces them, and sets the appointment. And they have, instead of 75% not showing up for an appointment, they have well above 75% who do show up. And so that warm handoff is very important. Likewise, a patient getting their teeth fixed, maybe the cause of bad teeth is diabetes. And so the dentist will do a warm handoff to the doctor, and so on. So this sense of integrative medicine is very, very helpful. But it goes way beyond medicine. You know, there are many things in our life. We may have a friend that is going through a difficulty, and we recommend something to him, and then just leave it at that. But if we do a warm handoff, put in that little bit of extra effort to help them do what we're recommending that they do, maybe it's, oh, you should get out more. Well, instead of just telling somebody you should get out more, you're isolated, take them out. Maybe introduce some other people that you think they might be compatible with. So go the extra step of doing a warm handoff for whatever problem you're dealing with. But now this is where it gets interesting. There's another layer to this, and that's within our own system. Think of the Western medicine taking care of the body, the counselor taking care of the mind. Well, we have a body, and we have a mind, and we have emotions, and we have a spiritual nature. And we need to learn to do a warm handoff to our own selves. So if we're dealing with something on a physical level, let's say a recurring physical problem, a chronic problem, shortness of breath, something like that we're having difficulty with, well, we should not just look at what the physical causes of that are, but also look at what might be the psychological or emotional causes of that, and do a warm handoff. So yes, we should work on the physical level. Of course we should. But we should also then, in our own selves, do a warm handoff from the physical level to the mental and psychological level, and look at what is maybe in our thought patterns, in our habit patterns, in our attitudes, in our emotions, that's causing the physical pattern that creates the problem. And then finally, we need to recognize that things emanate and originate on the spiritual plane. Paramahansa Yogananda said that all problems stem ultimately from spiritual ignorance. And so the physical plane, yes, is important. The mental, emotional plane, of course, is important. But we need to also work on that root cause, which is the spiritual ignorance that we have. And that spiritual ignorance, in this case, may be being expressed in one particular aspect of our being. One of the things that comes to mind, perhaps, is that we have different aspects of God that are present within the world and within each of us. But one of those aspects is love. So what if we are not having enough expression of love? Expression of love first to Divine Mother, expression of love to the forms in which Divine Mother has manifested in our lives. And so what if our heart is constricted and the heart energy and the lungs are related? They're in the same energy body, one might say, energy pattern. So perhaps the shortness of breath doesn't originate at all on the physical level. Perhaps the shortness of breath comes from a shortness of love. And if we work on all of these levels, spiritual, mental, emotional, and physical, and do a warm handoff from one level to the other, we have a much better chance of really getting to the root cause of what we're working on. God bless you.